So, you want to become a pro Standoff 2 player? Well then, you have come to the right place, because today I am going to be teaching you how to not be a sad nub like the majority of the Standoff 2 population.
Bomb has been planted.
You might be wondering why you should listen to my tips. Well, let me show you. Hopefully that was convincing enough. Now let's get into the... In your journey to becoming a pro, you will need a good device. Because playing below 30 FPS will slow you down and limit how well you can play. Imagine if you were to fight a copy of yourself, and one of you is playing at 15 FPS, and the other is playing at 60. Who do you think will win? Obviously the one that is playing at 60 FPS. I'd personally recommend using an iPad, because with an iPad you can play with 4 or even more fingers. Next, you will need to find the best controls and sensitivity that are right for you. Here you can see the controls that I am using at the moment. I have different controls for when I play with Sniper and AKR because it speeds up my reaction greatly. If you want to try out my controls, then go ahead. However, I do not recommend changing your sensitivity to mine, because you are used to yours and I am used to mine. And if you change sensitivity, then you could lose a lot of your skill. It has happened to me before. Once you have your controls ready, you need to learn the recoil patterns of your most used guns. Here you can see that the AKR's recoil pattern is shaped like a 7. And when we go against it, the spread becomes more concentrated. Try this yourself by practicing on a wall. The smaller the spread, the better you become. Now you will need to work on improving your game sense. This is mainly focused on maps. Learn all the maps and know them by heart. This is very important because you will know all the locations where the enemies can be camping, pushing, flanking from, etc. A lot of people don't know this, but you should join a clan. Clans are made to play on the competitive level. And there you will go through a lot of training on a daily basis. There can also be a very good player which you can learn from and improve your skill. 95% of all pro players are in clans and are learning from each other. However, if you are a busy person like me, I do not recommend you to join any clans. Like I said, there you are expected to be active on a daily basis. This next tip is pretty self-explanatory. You just need to play standoff 2 regularly to maintain your skill, or even improve it. If you do not do this, your skill will just simply wear off. I play standoff 2 mostly a couple of hours every day. There will be days when you don't have time to play, and that's normal. I have those days too. If you're mainly looking forward to improving your reaction time, then I recommend you to play a lot of team deathmatch. Why does it help, you might ask? Simply because of its repetitiveness. You will start to get used to killing everyone with ease, and you will want to do it even faster and better. I'd say most of the matches I have played are team death matches. Try this yourself and I can guarantee you that your reaction time will improve significantly after playing constant TDMs. Now comes the most complicated tip from this whole video. You will need to know your rotations. Let me explain what that is really quickly, because I am sure not everyone knows what it is. A rotation is basically a flank, or a plot twist if you want to call it that. Let's say I am pushing someone that is at B site. And out of nowhere he appeared behind me and killed me. That person that appeared behind me had a very good rotation. There are so many of them I'd have to make a separate video just for them. Tell me in the comments if you guys want to see me make a video about rotations. Another big aspect of standoff 2 is the recently added grenades. In my opinion, the flashbang is the most annoying grenade in the game, and I have gotten messed up by it many times now. The point here is that you can beat basically any pro player with the right use of grenades. And once again, there is a lot of good nade spots that you can do. Way more than there are rotations. If you guys want to see me make a video on good nade spots, then let me know in the comments. Right now though, I will link a couple of videos that will show you some pretty good nade spots. Shout out to their creators. And lastly, enjoy the game. Don't rage if you lose, even though a lot of people do rage. And a lot of you will still rage after listening to me telling you to not rage. Learn from your mistakes, and don't break your phone over again. That is all I have for today. Like, subscribe, and share. See you guys later.